Fact and follow-up segment tonight. Last week, we criticized the Colorado Speaker of the House, Mark Ferrandino, for not allowing the legislature out there to vote on Jessica's law. Jesse Waters confronted Ferrandino.
A 41-year-old soccer coach repeatedly raped a 13-year-old girl and only got 2 years in prison.
Specifically, I still do not know the specifics of the cases you're talking about. I'm happy to look at them if you can look at the cases. And if we need to toughen the laws in Colorado, we should and we will.
Well, you do need to toughen the laws, with all due respect, sir.
In describing Mr. Ferrandino to the national audience, I said he was openly gay, which he is, a fact that is noted in nearly every article written about him. Apparently, that offended the Denver Post, which editorialized on Sunday, quote, "May not surprise you to learn that a fact-challenged, bigoted line of attack came courtesy of a Fox News Channel talking head, specifically Bill O'Reilly. O'Reilly's fear-mongering should offend all Coloradans. He was saying gay, but what he wanted his listeners to hear was pervert, pedophile," unquote. Joining us now from the Mile High City is the man who wrote that, the editor of the Denver Post editorial page, Curtis Hubbard. So, you've got a nerve calling me a homophobe, number one. You can't back it up. Your editorial is libelous speculation. Is it not?
Let me correct you on a couple of things just to start. Number one, it's not an editorial. It's my column that appears each week Sunday, so it's my opinion, not the opinion of the editorial board.
All right, but you're the editorial page editor, correct?
Correct.
Okay, go ahead.
So, and I didn't call you a homophobe, but what I did do was call into question what Representative Ferrandino's sexuality had to do with his opposition to Jessica's law, which was the point that you were making.
Okay, and why did I bring up that he was openly gay? What was the context of that description?
You were trying to figure out why he opposed Jessica's law, and my question back to you is, what does his sexuality
did you see
have
the report?
To do with his
did you
opposition?
See the, did you see the report that we did? Did you see it on television? Not read the transcript. Did you see the report? Okay, good.
I saw it on television. And to make my
All right,
point,
so here, after, so I'm going to answer your question. I'm going to answer your question. I described Ferrandino to the audience because the audience doesn't know who the heck he is. And I did it in the context of what his priorities are. His priorities are civil unions, all right, which you guys are going to have pretty soon out there, and legalizing marijuana, which you already have out there. And he's a gay marriage proponent, as you know. So I said, here are Ferrandino's priorities. Here's what he spends his time on. All right. And Jessica's law,
but
he doesn't
Bill,
want.
You didn't introduce them as his priorities. And you can go back and look at the tape.
I did what absolutely say this is what the guy is promoting.
You asked your guest why he opposed Jessica's law.
Right.
And then you used his sexuality and his support for gay marriage as rationale for why he would oppose Jessica's law.
Oh, no, I didn't.
My
I didn't say anything of the kind.
The
I described who he was. I described who he was, who he says he is, all right? And that's it. I made no correlation between him being, quote unquote, openly gay and Jessica's law. And for you to say that
true.
I equated.
No, you're
look, now
fact,
you're now
your
you're
guest,
not telling the truth.
Your guest is the
look,
one who took
got,
your
I can
words
show,
and then said he's protecting somebody.
Listen, he's protecting the trial lawyers. That's who he's protecting. See, you are ridiculous. You're a ridiculous person, and a journalist. This is disgraceful to say that I described him as
a person,
you
Bill,
are.
Because no one here, other than Representative Szabo, no one in law enforcement, no one in the justice system in Colorado was supporting this bill.
Yeah, and
the
why
question
are they
remains,
not supporting it?
What does Representative Ferrandino's sexuality have to do with passage of Jessica's
okay.
law?
I already explained that to you. If you can't grasp it, I can't help you. You saying that I described him as openly gay, which is true, equates to me calling him a pervert pedophile, is a disgrace. It's a disgrace in any column. It's a smear. You're a smear merchant. That's what you do. You can't back it up. Now, do you support Jessica's law? No, you can't. You can't back it up at all. If you could, you would have put it in your vile little column. All you did was make this giant leap. That's your opinion. Fine. And your opinion is your opinion, but you're a smear merchant. That's a smear. That's what you do. Now, do you oppose Jessica's law? Do you oppose it?
Bill, I don't think the question here is whether or not I
no,
support
no, no.
it or
that's
I
the question
it.
Because that's what we are doing in Colorado. Do you,
no,
as the editorial page editor of the Denver Post,
about...
do you support Jessica's law or not?
Listen, I don't know enough about
you
it.
You don't
to
know
say
enough
not...
about it. So you write a column about our reporting
about
and you don't know enough about
it. I wrote a column about your comments on his sexuality.
Yeah, his description. Described him, the way he describes himself.
If you had simply said, Democrats in Colorado oppose Jessica's law, here's why, I probably never would have brought it up.
Look,
but the fact of the matter is that you used his sexuality to impugn his character and to
impugn
his character to your viewers.
I said what his priorities are as Speaker of the House.
Yeah.
Look, I'm going to post this on BillO'Reilly.com, the whole thing, so people can see what a charlatan you are. You can't win the argument. You don't know what you're talking about, Jessica's law. You run the editorial page on the most powerful paper in the state, and you don't know anything, and all you can do is smear.
I know.
That's all you can do.
That's not true.
You
Bill.
Don't know anything about Jessica's
earlier,
law. This has been
Jessica's
in play for 5 years out
here's
there.
Here's what I do know about Jessica's law.
What?
No one in law enforcement in Colorado supported it in 2007, 2009, or again this year.
Okay.
In fact, it's only brought up when the Republicans are in the minority in Colorado, not when they had the majority. It's been used against Democrats as a wedge issue politically.
Right, but you don't know whether you support it or not. All you know is that no one, and believe me, I'll get law enforcement from Colorado on here, and I'll make you look foolish on that statement. But you don't even know about it, and you're the editorial director of the Denver Post, and you don't know. Well, do you support it or not? Do you support it or not?
You have to ask me which version I'm supporting.
Which version?
Am I supporting the 2007 version that included
the mandatory 25 to life for rapists, child rapists?
This year's. I think that we have seen in our judicial system that mandatory sentencing oftentimes has unintended consequences.
All right, so you don't support it.
Colorado has strong sex offender laws.
Yeah.
I don't see any reason to change Colorado's sex offender laws.
I got a dozen child rapists doing less than 5 years in your state, Mr. Harvard. Maybe you ought to do a little research about it.
Lifetime probation, which is something unique to Colorado, which I've done research on.
Ooh,
lifetime probation for rape.
You know, if you had a kid and somebody raped that kid and they got lifetime probation, you'd probably be out there with a gun, Mr. Hubbard.
That's in addition to their prison sentences, Bill.
Yeah,
and
the two or three years that they got.
The terms of that
the
probation,
two or three years that they
go
got,
to
that's good.
There
the
are
soccer
2,
coach
people
that raped
in prison
the kid
in Colorado.
And got, just, all right, I'm just going to say it. You need to look up Delbert Wallace Stewart. You need to find out what that man did, what a Colorado judge gave him, and then you need to come back on this show and tell me you don't need Jessica's law. All right, Mr. Hubbard,
I can tell you I know about that case. Sure, I'm happy to come back and discuss it with you anytime,
Bill. Very good.